You know, you never know who your friends are going to be. And out here, you got to make friends with whoever you got. So this is the entrance to the ranch where we're hunting. It's a pretty desolate area out here, but it's pretty hilarious. So every time I come through, I see these four hanging around together. Two horses, a pig, and a donkey. And they're just content as could be out there getting along with each other. Don't you wish we could all get along like that? Wouldn't that be great? You see the mountains in the background where they stay midday. All kind of critters live here, especially in the Eastern Cape. There's plenty of them living wild. It's amazing. They come in and out of these fields at night. Pretty exciting. You never know what'll show up. Could kill a caracal cat. You never know.
Okay, so I'm in here with my cameraman Brent slash hunting buddy. He's always a nervous wreck, which is hard to get him to calm down because he's high strung, but we're pumped up because we're in the feeding zone, okay? So you can see that there's pretty green grass out here. We put alfalfa out in front of our blind. They put a pop-up blind for us, but every evening the animals come down out of the mountains and they feed out in here, a lot of impala, all your grazers. There's a herd of wildebeest that come in night after night after night. And there's even blessbuk and warthogs. So they've been throwing alfalfa out in front of this blind for about a week, and the animals are feeding in front of it. So I cut a little hole in my mesh to put my blowgun through right here. And Brent and I is pretty prepared to do some slogging. He's got his bow in case they don't get close enough. And hopefully I get one of these animals in here to, close enough to try the Viper blowgun on them. I got my new razor darts as well. Super sharp, twice as sharp too. And longer so that it goes all the way into the heart and lung on a big animal. So we're ready. You ready, Brent?
All right, let's do it. Let's see where these go down.
It's exciting.
I'm Tim Wells, the Slock Master, and I use Morel Targets, Carbon Express Arrows. I buy from Bass Pro and use cold steel knives. I kill animals with Grim Reapers. Advanced Taxidermy brings them to life. I use Muzzy for big fish and wear Mossy Oak Camo. My Oneida bow goes with me in an SKB case. I shoot Umarex air guns and fish from tracker boats. Fox Pro is my go-to call, and I drive a Ford truck because Ford trucks are tough.
Good. Hopefully those wildebeest don't run him off.
He stopped.
He's gonna go down. Viper blowgun. Slocked him good. About a 7-8 yard shot. Put it right in his heart. He didn't last long at all. That didn't take long. We've only been here about 45 minutes. Wildebeest showed up. I thought I was gonna get a good shot at them. Then this guy come walking right in there. That was perfect.
Give me somebody.
Bam.
Slock master's at it again.
We had some fun tonight. Let's go check him out.
All right, so here's our setup. I don't know what Primos makes that one, I guess. But anyway, the outfitter just threw this thing in. You can see they're not much into brushing in their blinds. If this was me, I'd have it all hid in there and nice and tight. But it worked good because they've been baiting the animals here for several days. Got alfalfa. I try to keep my bait when I'm hunting over bait with the blowgun close. I mean, you want the reaction time of the animal to be as minimum as possible. And so anything within 10 yards, you know, they can't get out of the way. And the Blessbuk ran out there, it looks like about 100 yards. And he deader than a doornail. Let's go check it out.
Do you own a blowgun or spear? Well, Slockmaster.com is where they're sold. We've got the best razor darts, blowguns, fishhawks, and spears right here at Slockmaster.com. They're just too much fun. Pick off a squirrel or rabbit while you're waiting on a deer, and bring home some hassan pepper for dinner. By golly, at Slockmaster.com, we sell the perfect gift. So check us out at slockmaster.com.
I'm having the time of my life. Give me a blowgun and send me in the woods and I'm as happy as a little kid in a candy store.
Look here. This is the, just sticking out right there. Let me show you something here. Zoom right in on that, Brent. Get a good picture of that. Those folks would never believe that. That's the tip of my blow dart. And I haven't moved him one bit. As God is my witness, I have. And there's the best spot to kill your animals. You come straight up the leg. Remember the leg bone, people are afraid to hit the shoulder, so they shoot back in here, but that's the bad spot. The leg comes straight up like this, but as soon as it meets the bottom of his belly, the bone turns and runs up this way. Right behind that right there is the heart. And with a blowgun, the shot has to be precise. You can shoot them in the lungs, but it takes a little longer for them to croak. But if you put it through the heart, they die quickly. And the razor dart has passed all the way through him. You can see there, all the way through that big guy. I will pull the cup off. Oh, man. Take that dart out. He bent it when he ran. But did the trick. The Slock Master's in town. Probably the only dang animal in Africa that's been slocked with a blowgun this morning. And I got a good one. It was fun. I tell you what, every time it happens, it's part of the cycle of life. And I like it.